Assalamualaikum. Hi. Here is our video presentation on car maintenance system. So our team consists of Ahmad Aizat, which is the leader, me, Muhammad Danish, and Ifan Ahmad. For the project methodology, we have choose prototype process model as our project methodology. For the stakeholders, our stakeholders consists of the customer, the administrator, the mechanic, and the receptionist. Our objective is we want to simplify the booking, the customer's detail to be in a database rather than to be on sheets of papers. Next, we want the booking process of customers to be in a systematic order. Next, we want to help the mechanic to update the stock easily. For the use case, our use case for the customer is booking maintenance. For the administrator, respond to booking as well as booking maintenance. For the mechanic, reconfigure maintenance part. And for the receptionist, keep track booking date. For the basic flow, for the tracking booking date for the receptionist, after we log in, first step, the receptionist need to check his or her personal details. So this, the system will display receptionist personal details. Second, the receptionist able to update his or her personal details. The system allow the changes made on personal details. Third, the receptionist has to check the booking schedule on the customer who has booked on that day. The system display the booking schedule. On the third step, that is the exceptional to which fourth, the receptionist has to update manually to assign a date to a customer. System allow an appointment to be created. Fifth, receptionist has to notify the customer that has the appointment on the current day, A1, the alternate flow 1. The system allows the receptionist to send notification to the customer through email. Six, receptionist validate the customer that come to the maintenance center. System allow the receptionist to key in the customer name to validate the customer's booking. For the alternate, next, for the alternate flow, first step is here on the fifth step in basic flow. The receptionist has to update his or her detail or to click on continue button to proceed. The system will allow the personal details to be updated or continue to the next page. The second step for the alternate flow, receptionist has to send notification to the customer or exit the notification process. System allow the receptionist to send notification to the customer or click the exit button to exit the notification process. Third, receptionist has entered the customer's name, but the system display customer's record if record is found or no record if record is not found. For the exceptional flow, the E1 is where here the sixth step. E1 is where the receptionist enter the customer's name in the system, but the customer name does not show because the customer have no appointment on that day, so the system will display empty customer name list. For the second, if E2, the third step, E2 here, the receptionist has to check the booking schedule for the customer who book on that day. So here is where the customer just come to the maintenance center without any booking. So it just walk in. So if the receptionist have entered the name and no record found on that day, the same will also not display the customer record, so the customer cannot proceed to the maintenance for the car maintenance system. So next, for our user interface design on tracking booking date, here is the main page for the receptionist. The receptionist has to sign up. If the receptionist have not owned an account, or log in if the receptionist has already owned an account, or and there is about us to no more to contact on the car maintenance center. So here is the page for sign in, which need to sign to fill in the email and the password, and for creating an account, the receptionist need to enter his name, his email, ID number, password. After that, the receptionist will get to see their own details such as first name and last name, email, password, ID number, phone number, city addresses, and the receptionist can update or just click on next button if there is nothing to update. And the receptionist can also log out if they want to log out. So here the customer list name that consists of name, phone, email, last appointment date and next appointment date. In this customer list, the receptionist can click and check on the name to make sure that the customer need to attend another near appointment or not. So here is the calendar which the receptionist need to click. So for example, the receptionist click on 19, and after click on 19, he need to fill in the details, the date, the time. The date is 19, the time, the customer name, the phone number and email, and after clicking on the create appointment, an email is sent to the customer. Here the testing for tracking booking date. For step that is successful, if the receptionist log in the system by enter the valid email and password such as this, the input is dan3@gmail.com for the email, and password is 1111 for password, and the expected output is log in successful and the result is passed because the email and password is valid. For the second step, if the receptionist log in the system by entering not valid email and password, for this the email dan3@gmail.co without m and 9999 for password, which is invalid username and invalid password, so the result is fail. Third, receptionist enter the name of the customer correctly, Johan, for the name, and Johan is the customer that have an appointment on that day, so the system will view the item name Johan, so result is passed. Next, the receptionist enter the name of the customer only, so the Noyan is not a name, is so the system will not view any item. The result is fail because there is no one name Noyan, or the customer is misspelled. The receptionist misspelled the customer's name. Here we are, we continue on Wix on prototype. So here is the login page where we need to enter the email and password. In my case, I have already owned an account, so I need to log in. But if the receptionist have no account, they can sign up here. So here is the main page, the home button, and here is the hello user, and the logout receptionist, the customer's booking, personal details, and under the personal details, there is the receptionist details and the details that he or she can update, and here is the about us button. For the personal details, on details, the receptionist can see the detail, the name, the email, the password, the number, the ID number, the number, and where did he live. So if he want to update, he can go to update details and fill in the details that he need to update to and click on the update button to update the changes. So next, we proceed to customer's booking. So for the customer's booking, here we first need to look to the customers and see on which customer that need to do the booking on next appointment. So if the next appointment, we need to notify the customer on that morning. The Wix is actually having a problem because here it has the link on send email, but if we click on the send email, it will bring us to a blank page. So we need to do it manually on calendar, and we pick a date 18, and we add a new appointment. So for 18, we need to notify the customer earlier, at the AM, and the booking will be on 10 AM. So the client name is then on, and the phone number and the email. So I use this email just to prove that this really works. Here email a copy of this booking to my customer. So by clicking this create an appointment, it will send an email to this email. So here click the email and it will be booked. So the email will notify the customer. So here is the car maintenance system. Thank you for booking with Ali. Okay, that's all.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Irfan. I'm gonna explain about the mechanic character actor of game mechanic. And for the precondition of the mechanic is should log in as the mechanic. And the flow is first the mechanic chooses the service type. The system will display the service type that requested by the customer, and the mechanic chooses an inventory. System display the inventory page. And for the third, mechanic check the number of current stock available. The system will display the number of stock, and mechanic make an order for a stock renewal. System will navigate to the order page. And at the last stage, in the last step is mechanic make a purchase for the stock. System forward the message, your item is successfully purchased. And for the alternative flow is mechanic does not make any purchase. If he thinks that the stock is the stock required is will sufficient for the next other update, that's for the upcoming days for the maintenance, so he will not make any other purchase. And for the exceptional flow, the stock requested not available, and the system will display the stock is currently unavailable. Okay, the post condition for this system is maintenance type is confirmed, inventory will be updated, include an extension point, mechanic should be alert with the inventory and customer maintenance requirement, and only this special requirement is display the service type and the name and the detail of customer encrypted. Business rules are the number of orders should be tallied with the maintenance number. Okay, for the interface design for mechanic, first the homepage, where in the homepage they will display the name, position, contact number, and address. And in the service type, there will be the service type 1, 2, 3. What are the service types in? And the number of customer will be listed down. And for the inventory report, the item, number of stocks, and there will be a button order now. When they click the button order now, and it will navigate the page order where the items and the price will be displayed, and with the button by now, if you click the button by now, it will purchase the item. And for the testing, we tested on two, for the successful purchase and unsuccessful purchase. And for the successful purchase, as we know, the precondition is Magani must be logged in with the valid username and check the stock inventory for the maintenance. He should check first before doing the purchases. Once the purchase is done, the stock inventory is updated. And the steps are: navigate to web page, navigate to car maintenance system page. The web page should be displayed, and mechanic is navigate to the home page. The status is passed. Check for the service type that has been to be done on the particular day. Page should display the service type has to be done, and the page display date with the number of customer. Pass. Check the inventory. Page display the inventory page. Page show the number of stock that available. Click on order button, navigate to the order page. The page order display with the price of item. Mechanic chooses the item to be purchased and click buy now button. And for the test data, we test with the break all the item. Expected result, the item will be purchased. And actual result is mechanic should be informed by the pop-up message with a thanks message. Status all are passed. And for the unsuccessful purchases, as for the following successful method, it will undergo the same process until the click on button. Click on order button, and when it reaches, the mechanic chooses the item to be purchased, and the click buy now button. We test it with another data with the item brake pad. The item will be purchased, and the actual result will be the mechanic should be informed by the pop-up message out of stock, and for the purchases it is failed. Okay, now we will proceed with the demo. Now we see the prototype of the mechanic, how it will go on, or how will that work. Okay, the first, when the mechanic logging into the system as a mechanic, the home page will display about the mechanic detail, the name, the position, and the contact address of them. Okay, when he login, then he will choose service type. And then in the service type, there will be the list of the services and maintenance that will be done on that particular day. Example as normal service 5, or brake check 6, and so on. And if the mechanic will check the inventory frequently to get up to date to the stock that available. Maybe because he fears that sometimes it will be clear of stock, then they there will be hardship in their maintenance process. That's why he should keep on tracking on the stock numbers. So in the inventory, there will be an available of list item and the stock that is still available. If he wish to do an order, he can place an order in order now. In the order now, there will be the list of item and the cost per the cost for the item, and with the click buy now button, which the customer wish which the mechanic wish to buy. For example, we can buy the brake oil. Click the buy now. There will be a prompt of message showing that your order has been received. Thanks for purchasing. So if the mechanic said done, he will proceed to the home page. If if he wish to do another order, he can click order now, and he can do, for example, he want to buy brake pad, your order has been rejected, we are out of stock. So it indicate that there's a unsuccessful purchase, where maybe he could do this one. Okay, I think that's all. That's all for the interface. Thank you.
Hello, hello, assalamualaikum. So today we will show you our website for car maintenance system. So basically all user have to own an account before we can book, before we can proceed to use this website. So if you don't have an account, you can go to sign up and fill in your email, password, and if you already have, just in this case I have created one, so I just need to log in my email and my password. So just log in. So here the homepage, there you can navigate to personal details about the website and book online, and you also can log out if you have nothing to do. So first, when you log in, you can go to detail, your personal detail, where you can see your detail such as your name, your email, your password, and your ID number, your phone number, and as well as your address number. So next, if you want to change your detail, you want to update them, if you think that you need a new name or you have moved to another place, so you can navigate to update details. So this when you can update your customer details and update them. Next, you can go to car details, where the car details show your car details such as your registration number, the car type, the car model, the car version and the car transmission, as well as the car fuel type and the car engine size, the CC. Here it helps you to show the car maintenance due date, where in 7 days your car need to go to this workshop to have the car monthly maintenance system. So after that, you can go to booking.
So for the booking process, the customer can click the booking button at the car details page, and also they can click the booking buttons at the customer details, or they can directly click the book online button on the page, which will directly lead the customer to the booking page. So after you click the button to start the booking process, the page will show you a calendar and the dates that available for the maintaining process. As you can see, there are a bold dates and a faded date. This will indicate that the dates is not available for the maintenance process. So if you click the faded date on the Monday buttons, there are no available hours, because the available hours for the maintenance process are full, so the customer cannot book for that date. So the customer need to choose another date that is available for them. As example, on the 24. If the dates that the customer choose are available, so the page will show the hours that the customer can choose for the maintenance date. So example, the customer choose to do their maintenance at 3 p.m. so they need to click the next button for the confirmation. And here the customer need to fill the form for the booking details. And here the customer can put any message or leave a feedback for the company, or also the message for example for the company about their cars. So the customer need to click the book it button for the confirmation for the maintenance for their car. And here it will show the details that the customer have chosen for their maintenance process of their car. Because if the customer desire to cancel the booking or change the date, they can directly click this cancel button, which will cancel all the date that they have booked during the booking process.
Okay, after the customer book, they may click the button confirmation slip for their booking slip. Here the booking slip will display the booking ID, which will be generated by its own, and the full name, then service type, date, car registration number, the car which car they choose, and the date where they which one they choose for their booking. If the customer wish to go back, they may go back to the previous page for the booking details. If the customer save, it will proceed to the new booking. Okay, that's all. Thank you about our car booking, car maintenance system. Thank you.
On the first page, it will show the home button and the button for the admin to click for the list of customers that have made the booking. And then after clicking the button, the page will show the list of customers they have made booking, and the list is sorted by the date made by from the customer for the booking. And here is the status whether the admin have respond or not. So if the admin want to respond to one of the customer, the admin will click this button, and then the page will show the booking details made by the customer. And then the admin will choose whether to approve or decline the booking made by the customer by looking at the details on the booking slip, whether it meet the characteristic of the booking. And then the page will show whether the booking is approved or the booking is declined by the admin. And then the list of customer will be updated whether the booking is approved or declined. So for the testing for the response to customer booking, okay, this test case is respond to customer's booking, which is the administrator will respond to customer's booking made by the customer on the web. So the administrator will respond to customer's booking whether to approve or decline the booking made by the customer. So this is the description of the test case. The priority is high, and then the module name is respond to booking. Test title is approve or decline the customer's booking by the administrator. Okay, this test will test about the response to customer's booking made by the administrator. So the precondition of this feature is the admin must log in with valid username and password, and then choose the customer's booking that he wish to respond to. The post condition is when this case is done, the customer's booking is whether approved or declined, and notification will be sent to customer regarding their booking status. So the flow of the event is first that the admin will navigate to the web page. So the test data is navigate the car to the car maintenance system page, and the expected result is the list of the customer's bookings page should be displayed, and the actual result is administrator is navigated to the list of customers booking page for the status is passed. The second step is the administrator will choose the available customer on the list which have been sorted. As an example, the test data is one of the customer, Dan Danish, and the expected result is the page should able to display the booking details made by this particular customer, and the actual result is the page shows the booking details by the customer. So the status is passed. And for the third step is approve or decline booking. So the customer will decide whether to approve or decline the booking. So the test data is the customer's booking, whether being approved or declined by the administrator. So the expected result is page should display whether the booking is approved or declined, depend on administrator's choice. So the actual result is page display the whether the booking is approved or declined based on administrator's choice. So the status is passed. So the special requirement is the details of the customer and the car are encrypted and secure from the other misuse. Notification is sent to the customer through web and email about the booking status, and the booking is failed if the administrator did not respond to the booking within 3 days. And then the test case, the second is the unsuccessful response to the customer's booking. So this is the response process to the customer booking is unsuccessful because the administrator did not respond to the booking within 3 days of the date booked by the customer. So this is the test case description, which is the test priority is high, the module name is respond to booking, the test title is approve or decline the customer's booking by the administrator, and description is test to respond to customer's booking. Okay, so the precondition the same, administrator must log in with valid username and password and choose customer's booking to respond. The post condition is the customer's booking fail and notification is not sent to the customer regarding their booking status. Okay, so the flow of event, the step one is navigate to the web page. So the test data is the page will navigate to the car maintenance system page, and the expected result is the list of customers booking page should be displayed, and the actual result is the administrator navigated to the list of customers booking page. So the status is passed. So for the step 2 is choose available customer on the list. This is the test data, which is one of the customer, Dan Danish, and the expected result is page should be able to display the booking detail made by the customer. The page show the booking detail made by the customer, and then the status is passed. So the third step is approve or decline the booking. So the customer's booking approve or decline by the administrator. The expected result is page should display whether the booking is approved or declined, depend on the administrator's choice. But the actual result is the booking failed because the administrator did not respond to the booking within 3 days. So the status here is failed. So a special requirement for this part is the details of the customer and the car are encrypted and secure from the other misuse. Notification sent to the customer through web and email about the booking status. And lastly, booking is failed because the administrator did not respond to the booking within 3 days.
Okay, for the respond to booking part by the admin. First, the admin need to log in as admin into the website. And this is the homepage of the website. And the admin will choose the customer's booking button in the website. The website will display the list of customers that have made booking for their car maintenance, and the list name of the customer will be listed according to the booking date made by the customer. So the customer who booked earlier for the car maintenance will be responded by the admin earlier than those who book the date later. So here the admin will choose the customer that he prefer to respond for their booking. So after the admin choose the customer for the booking, it will display the booking details made by the customer, and here the admin will decide whether to approve or to decline the booking made by the customer based on the booking details, whether it meet the requirement of the company and fulfill the characteristic of the booking for the maintenance. So if the admin click the approve button, so the booking for the customer is approved, and a notification will be sent to the customer through the website and also the email, and then it will show at the list of the customer that the customer's booking has been approved by the admin.